10,000 milliamp hour 4S26650.
Jobs are good. This is one of the nice things about these kind of battery packs. I've done a standard like slanted shape because that's what makes sense for me in the mini talon. I can stuff it in there. But if you needed a battery of a random design or something bespoke to meet your own requirements, so for example, maybe you needed to make a strange pack where you have, again, I'm going careful with that pack, maybe where you needed 4 cells, or maybe you wanted a 6S and you wanted to make it like that, where those cells are up on an angle, or maybe you wanted to make a 4S battery pack like that, or make a square one, or whatever design or layout of battery cells you wanted, you can do that with these cells, because the only thing which is holding you back is either your imagination or your use case, something which I perhaps missed earlier on in the beginning. Actually, I'm going to cut this back into the beginning, because when it comes to these 18650 packs, you're not like saying you've got to have a rectangular pack like a typical LiPo. If you've got a specific use case, then heck, you could make a little 3S like that, or a 3S like that, or a 5S like that. It's really the only thing which comes to the creation of the battery, the setup, the way they're laid out, really is just down to A, your imagination, and B, the practicality of getting the wires going to go across them. Howdy, I'm Matt, and in this video we are going to be discussing 2650 Lion battery packs. Now, as many of you will recall from the Rag the Nuts of Facebook group, a couple of weeks back we had a massive box, of these 26650 batteries. Need to get that right, yeah. The 26650 batteries arrive from Aliexpress. Now, there was a lot of discussion about these, whether I should have gone for these or for 18650s, and that's what we're going to be discussing here. And also, you may have noticed some of these batteries all lined up over here nice and neatly, because we will be soldering those up together very shortly as well. Now, those of you which have not come across the Lion battery packs just yet, or maybe you know LiPo, but Lion, why would you go for Lion over LiPo? Well, the simple answer is that LiPo batteries, which most of us as RC pilots are very used to, they're very cheap, they have a very high power density, and they're readily available in multiple different sizes. I'll put a screenshot of me scrolling through Hobby King on their website, and you'll see that there's a whole massive plethora of different batteries and sizes available to us. And convenience is a big thing when it comes to LiPo batteries, especially for us as RC modelers. However, those of you which are looking to push what you can do out of LiPos are going to hit this wall. Now, like I said, LiPo batteries have a very good balance between cost and power density, so and weight is another big thing for us because we're flying RC models. Now, the thing is that if you want to get past out of those boundaries, we need to put price to one side for a moment, when it comes to weight, to the amount of battery which you can pack into a model, is that yes, you can go bigger and bigger on pack sizes, but then it comes weight and weight and weight, it just gets heavier and heavier and heavier. And that's where Lion batteries, generally speaking, come into their own. What we've got in front of us here, and let me just go and zoom in so you can see this, is that these are 26650 batteries. Now, you may be wondering, well, Matt, I've heard about 2650 batteries. Sorry, I've never heard of these 26650 batteries, but I have heard of 18650. Now, let me just zoom back out again. You'll notice that I've got my Fat Shark goggles over here to one side, and I've got this funny little pack, and in here, I got fed up with those 2S packs because the balance leads always broke on them. And what we've got here is an 18650 battery. So those of you which are vapes or have got those high power torches, you will have come across these before. Now, this battery specifically is the LG INR, and they're the 3500 packs. Now, these are an 18650. Now, 18650 and 2650, what's the difference? Well, the size, and that's what those numbers mean. These are 18 millimetres across by 6.5 centimetres or 65 millimetres long. That's what the measurements mean. So if we now know that with the 18650, we've got 26650, we now know it's supposed to be 26 millimetres, so 2.5 centimetres across by 650 long. This is why they're exactly the same length, just one of them is a little bit fatter round the middle. So that's the difference between the two. Now obviously, because this battery is bigger, we've got a higher capacity. So the LG ones, which I've got here, and again, I'll put links to these in the video description for you. These are rated for 3,500 milliamperes, whereas these Lycola, I'm just gonna muller the name, so we'll just call them Litz, or Kalas, batteries are rated up to 5,000 milliamperes. So just put that into perspective. There's my hand, there's a 5,000 milliampere 1S battery pack. So if you got a second one and we welded them or soldered them together, that would be a 5,000 2S pack, or we got another one, that would be then be a, that would be a 1,500 3S pack. Now the caveat to this is that when it comes to lithium batteries, is that generally speaking, is that the amount of current which they can deliver is an awful lot less. So if you think about the traditional LiPo battery, is that that could potentially dish out over 100 amps easily, especially some of the high C packs, whereas the C ratings on this LG battery specifically is only 10 amps. And to be honest, that is not, that's quite high. There are higher rated, continuous rated amps, 18650 batteries out there, but generally speaking, 10 amps is quite high for an 18650 battery. When it comes to these 26650 batteries, they are rated for 20 amps continuously. So that's why you see people then putting them in quad, or they put them in parallel, so that if this was a 2S battery, so that would be Rony rated. So imagine 2S battery, well, no, but put it this way around. So imagine that battery light just like that. That's only rated for 5,000 milliamperes and 20 amps maximum draw on it. Whereas if you put another battery and join them up, like that, so you've got positives to positive, negatives to negatives, is that you would then increase the current capacity, the storage capacity, because you've now got 10,000 milliamperes available to you. And by the way, this isn't BS. Go and look up, again, like I said, I'll include links in the video description, because these have been well documented. But by putting them in parallel, like so, is that not only do you double the capacity, but you also double the current delivery from this, so that you would now be up to a maximum of 60 amps. But again, that's only a 1S battery, okay? So they have the same, pretty much the same voltage range as a LiPo, but you have a higher power density which goes with them. Hope that makes sense, and we have covered the differences between parallel and series in previous videos here on YouTube. Now, one thing to note is that a few moments ago I did say we had to put price to one side. Now, the reason why we needed to put price to one side is that your typical LiPo battery, like I said, it's very, very convenient, and it's also relatively inexpensive in the scheme of things. So let's talk about price specifically here, because these 18650 batteries can be picked up for around about £5.65 here in the United Kingdom, which is, again, it depends where you buy them, and do buy them from reputable sources. I can't stress that enough. It will be anywhere between, say, $5 to $7 US for just one of these cells. So you could be paying exactly the same for a 3S battery pack or less from a LiPo format, and that's only a 1S, so keep that in the back of your mind. Now, these are, I bought them direct from the manufacturer on Aliexpress, and like I said, I'll include links and stuff in the video description. And these were only $4 each. So these are rated for 5,000 milliampere. These are only 3,500. And these have a greater capacity. Can you understand now why they perked my attention? obviously, they're a little bit heavier. These only weigh 49 grams each, and these weigh 95 grams. Now, we've mentioned cost. These are definitely more expensive compared to LiPo batteries, but on the opposite side, they have a greater power density. Now, let's talk about power density here. I've got some notes here in the background. Is that We'll start with the 18650. Again, this is the LG INR from 3500 milliampere ones. These have a power density of 71.4 milliamperes per gram. So for each gram which you of these batteries you pack into the model, they have a power density of 71.4 milliampere hours, which is a lot, okay? Whereas these larger 26650 batteries only have a power density of 52.6 milliamperes per cell. So, that for me, okay, you may be thinking these might be bigger, we might have 5,000 in here, but if we put more of these in here, we'd have less weight and more power. But the thing is that size, these packs, and again, if you, especially if you're soldering up yourself, is that it's easier to solder two cells together and then make a 4S pack like I've got over there, compared to I would have to do four, I'd have to do at least three of these, again, including an extra eight welds at least, or solder joints, to get to the same capacity. So for me, that's why my attention or my ears picked up when I saw these batteries for literally $4 each from Aliexpress. And they had really good high capacity on them, 5,000. Now, don't get caught out by the product code on there, LII 550 amps. 50 amps is the burst current. These can only be set up, or should only be pulling 20 amps maximum per cell. Now, the caveat to that we just had spoke a few moments ago, is that, or in fact, why don't we do that right now so it makes a little bit more sense to you, is that I'm going to be setting mine up for a 4S pack, so I will be doing top and tail on them, like so. Get that the right way around. Or if I put them around that way, it'll make more sense. Okay, let's get ourselves zoomed right in as one of them starts to leg it off the screen. Right. Okay, so we got positive there. So what we'll do is put a red wire coming out here, going to our XT60 connector from this connector. Obviously, we'll glue these together as well. We've got the negative, and then we'll join it into the positive down here, and then the power circuit will go like that, all the way around to the negative terminal on here, where we'll also have the black wire to our XT60 connector, and then that will create ourselves a 4S battery pack. Now, those of you which are wondering about balance leads, it's very, very straightforward, and you literally can't go wrong, especially if you've got a multimeter, because what you do, you need to buy the balance leads separately, and then what you would do is put it on each joint. So you'd put one, and again, you need to check. I'll put a wiring diagram up on the screen for you. So we'll have the positive there, then we'll have the next voltage, that's measuring the voltage across this cell, so that'll be the 1S. Then we'll put a solder it here as well, so that'll be the 2S. Two batteries, two cells, and then we'll have another one down here which is 3S, so 1, 2, 3, and then we can measure the voltage, and then we've got a 4S on there which is the top one, and then that lead will then go to the top one in the connector. Like I said, I'll put a photograph on the top so it makes a little bit more sense. So that will now, if I made this pack up and we soldered it all up and popped it in our model, we would potentially have access to a 5,000 milliampere 4S battery pack. Does that make sense? We've got four cells. So that's the 4S, and then we're getting 5,000 milliamperes because that's what each cell is worth, okay? They're all in series, okay? And that would be fantastic, okay? For smaller models, is the 5,000 milliamperes would be crazy. I don't know where that 18650 battery's just wandered off to. There's one here. I use a 4S pack just like this with the 18650s in the Nano Talon. And it flies for days. If you imagine that with a 4S pack of these 18650s in a Nano Talon, that means that I've got 3,500 milliamperes, and to be honest, I never push it beyond 3,000 if I'm honest. But if I'm only cruising at 6 amps, you do the maths. Basically equals very long flight time. Absolutely brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. So these 26650 batteries are going to be going in my Mini Talon. So whereas that it would be prohibitively expensive for me to use 18650 batteries, again, high quality ones, with decent power ratings on them, again, 10 amps, 3500 milliamperes rated, okay, this route would be really quite expensive. This, while expensive, is no way as expensive for me going the 18650 batteries. That's why you saw loads of them on my desk. Right, let's get ourselves back onto topic, because we were chatting about cells. Now, here's the thing. There, we've got a 4S battery pack, 5,000 milliamperes, and a maximum of 20 amps, because each cell is only rated for 20 amps. And remember, the magic pixels, they go through all the way, well, technically, they go all the back ones, but for common usage, is the current flows in that way, and the electrons move, blah, 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 and they go through, okay? Now, this is where I'm sure you've heard, or may not have heard, of Ps, okay? So this is a 4S 1P battery pack. So we've got four cells, and there's one set of batteries in parallel, okay? This is where things get interesting, because if we mix in a second set of row, or second row of batteries, to this, like so, is what we now have is a 4S 2P battery pack. And of course, if we added more ins in there, we would then have a 4S 3P, 5, 4P, and so on and so forth. Okay, the P means in parallel. Now, by adding additional batteries in parallel, is that we now double the capacity and we double the current usage. So we would, if we soldered this up right now or welded this up, we would then have a 10,000 milliampere battery pack rated, because that's double, because you've got two cells here together, so they're able to deliver 10,000 milliamperes, 10,000, sorry, 10,000, 10,000, 10,000, 10,000 combined. Okay, so that gives us our 10,000 milliampere pack. Okay, and also the current is doubled as well. So this pack would now be able to deliver 40 amps from this pack. Now, if we're discussing again, this is definitely going in the Mini Talon, is that if my Mini Talon only cruises anywhere between, say, 4 to 7 amps, depending on what we're doing with it, is, and up on maximum throttle, we may go into 20, 25 amps, give it for like full beams to go forwards, like in a takeoff or a landing abort scenario, is that we're well within the specifications of the batteries. And compare that, so what we've got there is the, and I'm just taking a wander across to the battery supply over there. Oh, and with that, the thing goes mental as well. Go really mental, I'll move that out of the way. Is that normally I fly the, it really is going bonkers, let me sort that out a moment. And we're back. So, talking about LiPo batteries, this is the Multistar 5200 Tensi pack. This is normally what I use in the Mini Talon. And to be honest, that's what I probably suggest to you as well, because these are really, really cheap. These are only about 20 quid, depending if they're on sale or not. And they're 5,200 milliamperes. So the easiest way of comparing this LiPo pack is that it's just like that, okay? So there's our 4S1P pack, and this one is actually rated to 52 amps because it's Tensi rated, and yeah, like for like, happy days. However, for a slightly little bit more weight and a slightly little bit more height or bigger battery pack, we've just been and doubled the capacity which is available to us, and thus we'll have a longer flight time. Now, like I said, for the most of you out there watching this video, I would strongly suggest that you just go with these Multistar Tensi packs. They're inexpensive, they're readily available, and they're really good. However, those of you which are looking for greater efficiency, longer range, better capacities, then the 26650s are almost kind of like a no-brainer. And again, those of you which have got deep pockets, the 18650 battery would be the route to go. Those of you which are on a budget, like myself, then the 26650 batteries, especially these Litota Kala batteries, are just like no-brainers, because they're only $4 each. You can literally buy 10 of them for $40. Really, really good value for money. Now, when it comes to soldering these packs up or welding these packs up, now, in an ideal world, you would have one of those spot welders, okay? And there are companies out there which will be able to spot weld these for you. However, I don't have a spot welder, and there's always this big concern that you shouldn't put too much heat from your soldering iron into the actual cell itself. Now, this is one of the nice things about these cells, and if I zoom in, you'll see what I mean, is that if we zoom right in, and I'll hold that still, like so, I don't know if you can see, but up underneath there, this top pad is actually away from the actual cell itself. Thus, we can feel quite confident we can put a fair amount of heat in the top of this, maybe from a soldering iron, and not to panic too much. Now, as for the bottom of the cell, is that yes, we're going to need to be cautious on that. Now, a couple of tips for you when you're soldering up your cells is, number one, know what you're doing. There are plenty of videos on YouTube which show you how to solder up these. I'm just going to give you a very high level overview, and also don't forget that you need to know what you're doing with your balance leads as well, because you'll definitely want to balance charge these batteries as well. Now, a couple of tips for you is make sure you sand every surface which you're going to be soldering. So what I've done, you may notice the scratches on the top and the bottom of these cells. All I've done, just gone in there and just scratched the surface, just to make sure that when we do put some solder on them, well, I put some solder on in a few moments' time, is that we're going to get, we got something for the solder to grab hold of. Also, a massive tip for you is to get one a hold of these flux pens. Now, you can pick these up for about 2-3 quid off eBay, and they're absolutely fantastic. All you do is it's just flux, which helps or stops the oxidization, and it helps the solder to flow more easily. And all I'm going to be doing just before I solder is just push down on the tip of the pen, do a circle on the bottom, and then I'll solder on, and the solder will typically go wherever the flux has been, and it will just enable you to get the solder down onto each cell much more quickly. Now, when you're soldering these up, use your common sense. You need to get in and out very quickly, and for goodness sake, wear safety equipment while you're doing this. And again, sticking with tips, is get yourself some solder and pull the solder up on the end of your soldering iron nib. Now, obviously mine's all burnt and crispy, I'm sure we'll get some comments about that, but don't panic, I've got a little cleaner finger on the side. Again, it's not even hot. The note here is pull up a load, actually it's still on, I'll take that back, so we'll clean that up. And all we do, and all you would do, is get your soldering iron, make sure it's nice and hot. And by the way, I always get these questions about soldering irons. Matt, which one do you go for? I went for the cheapest possible soldering iron from Screwfix at £8.99. And then I bought some silver line tips, which were, I think, about 3 quid off Amazon, because the original one was terrible. And this is still the first tip, and I've had it for like 8 months now, and it's still pretty much in one piece. And then as far as solder goes, I bought the cheapest solder available off Amazon, and this stuff is really, really good. Anyway, getting back to my topic. On here, pull up the solder on the nib of your soldering iron, so you've got a little drip about to form. And then when you put it in on the top of your cell, you've already put some flux on the top of there, and then all you're doing is just guiding it down and dropping it in onto the top of the cell. And the idea is that you get in, count to two, and get back out again. Okay, and the reason for that is that on other cells, maybe perhaps over here on these 18650 battery packs, is that too much heat into these, you basically, and you can damage either the cell or worst case yourself and blow the tops off them. That's obviously very extreme circumstances, but just like I said, use your common sense. Goggles, glasses, blah, 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 okay? And all I'll be doing on mine, like I said, just going round, spot of, and then I'll do them all together at the same time, like so. And to be honest, I'll do the bottoms first, because otherwise, if we've got a lump of solder on the top of here, it's going to be rocking around on the desk. So we do the bottoms first, like so. I'll go through, put a load of flux, or a decent amount of flux on each of the bottoms of them, like so. Nice big chunks like that. And then for each of them, all I'm going to be doing, cleaning up the nib, making a puddle on the end of the soldering iron, and then just dipping it on. And then what I'm after is a little pool of solder, which is on the bottom or each pad of each cell. And the reason for that is that I've got some nickel metal strip here. Now, I need to find it. It's underneath my desk somewhere. My plan here was to, number one, give you like an overview to these types of this type of battery, and then give you the reasons behind why I've gone this way, why I'm going this route for a few select models, aka Mini Talon. And I get these soldered up, then what I'll do with the nickel wire is then solder them on. And then the idea with the nickel wire is that it cuts it to the right length, or glue these batteries together in the right order. then cut out where we want the exact lengths of wire, and then you pre-tin the wire. So that on the wire which is going across, you've already put the solder on it. So when, if you imagine that my pen is the wire, is that all you do is heat up the wire with a pair of, obviously holding onto a pair of pliers. So you've got solder which is molten on your wire, and then just drop it down on the top, and then it becomes very, very quick, and you can be in and out from doing that weld in literally less than a second to join it up. So yeah, in worst case scenario, you've had 2 seconds with each cell to put the blob of solder on it, and then 1 second afterwards. And again, if you're in very, very quickly and you're out very quickly, happy days, this thing should be relatively safe. But remember, put those safety squints on your head, because yeah, it's just common sense. So yeah, there we go. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go and get these soldered up, and they are the like Tocola batteries, Melinda and names I know, but like I said, $4 for, and you know they're the right ones. A, because I bought directly from the manufacturer on Aliexpress, but B, they've got the gravity in them. They really do feel like 95 grams. You can always tell the cheap batteries because they just don't have any weight in them. If you go to like the pound shop, for example, buy the little nickel metal high drive ones, you got like 50 million of them for £1. Pick them up and there's no weight in them. What you want to be seeing, especially with these 18650 batteries, is heavy batteries. Heavy batteries mean more charge available to you. And that is actually the biggest difference between the 18650s and these 2650s, is that this one is pretty much crammed to the max. If you see any 18650 battery which is rated for over 3500 milliampers, BS. Okay, absolute BS. Do not buy, do not waste your money on them, okay, because they're lying to you. The same with these 26650 batteries, 5000 milliampers is the cap. You can only cram so much capacity into such a small cell. Okay, so always keep that in the back of your mind. The maximum cap is 3500 milliampers for 18650s, and when it comes to these 26650s, 5000 milliampers is the max for these as well. So, with that said, I'm going to go and get these soldered up, and I'll show you the finished pack at the end. Now, I may carry on record, this will get broken over. I've got things to do today as well, so we'll do a little montage, if that makes sense, of me just working through these. And like I said, I've got to find the nickel wire as well, and then you'll see a little speeded up version of me just making these packs. And remember, keep in the back of your mind, I am personally choosing not to wear safety gloves, but for you, I would suggest that, and I've definitely got a pair of safety squints on my noggin as well. So with that said, let's go and hit fast forward, and I'll catch you at the end. Let's go! This is far as I've been and got now. You'll notice that we've got, if I put it around this way, so we've got positives, negatives, positives, negatives. And all I've done is just gently gone in there with a hot glue gun. Oh, a massive tip for you, I did actually turn this on. You may have seen me doing it earlier, but I didn't actually click the switch on all the way. You can use a blowtorch on the top nib to speed things up massively. So yeah, do take that as a little tip. One of these little blowtorches come in very, very handy for many different things, including speeding up the hot glue gun. So anyway, coming back to the batteries, you'll notice that I've put a copious amount of hot glue between each of these cells. I will now go on and put some glass fibre tape around the outside of them, these batteries as well. Now, if you've not seen this tape before, it's just the glass weave tape, which can be picked up relatively inexpensively. Again, probably eBay is your best source for this stuff. Very, very cheap. And again, the idea here is to just to keep the batteries in the same place. And again, if you can imagine like a unscheduled landing, you want the battery pack to survive. So yes, we are adding additional weight by using hot glue and tape and things like that. But what we are doing is ensuring that the integrity of the battery pack. So I will put some glass fiber tape around this way around to begin with, just to secure them all in place. And then we'll go on to solder all the points up as well. But then afterwards, I will then wrap it over the top as well with this glass fiber tape, and then finish the pack off with some colored tape on as well, just to make it look a little bit more prettier than what it is now. Okay, you will have seen me use an awful lot of force with this tape, because it's reinforced tape, and that's really is to ensure that each one of these cells are really stuck together, are gonna be held together as well. So with that said, I'm gonna go and find that nickel tape, and we'll get it on the top of these as well. Brilliant. Brilliant, I've been and found it. Actually, I found it very quickly, so I'm actually quite surprised. This is nickel tape, so it's metal, which is in a strip. Okay, or in a reel, and you can cut it off to any length that you see fit. Now, there is a massive word of caution which comes with the next couple of steps, is that what you are now going to be doing is that each of these cells are perfectly fine, okay, by themselves. Okay, we've put some solder on the top of them, we've put some hot glue down the sides, we've taped them up together. However, just be 100% aware, the second you start putting these across the top, you need to know what you're doing. So what the process which I'm going to be following to begin with is that I'm going to connect up, but again, you need to make sure you've got positives together and negatives together. So I'll put one strip across the top of there, one across there, one across there, one across there. I will also repeat that on the bottom, and that will probably be absolutely fine. The challenge or the issue becomes is that we'll then start joining these up horizontally across as well. And that's where you are going to be dealing with a live battery pack. And of course, if you do this wrong, you are going to end up with lots of magic pixie smoke in here in the background. So my advice for you is that if you've been watching this video and you're uncomfortable on any of the steps which we've been covering, is not to do it yourself. Go and speak to one of your buddies, or find a company who can do this for you. Okay, I'm quite comfortable in doing this. I've done it several times before, and like I said, there's plenty of videos on YouTube which will take you through the exact steps step by step. But for me, all I'm going to do is join up all the terminals here at the top separately. So I'm going to do those two together, those two negatives together, two positives. I'll do the same on the bottom, and then I'll join these cells up. And the idea is then we'll end up with positive here. Okay, so just going back to what we were saying earlier, we got positive here, the current, again, we join up these at the bottom too, so the current comes up, round, down here, out there, and then we end up with a negative terminal there, so we'll put a positive wire here and our negative wire there. And what I'll do, I'll show you at the end as well, the finished actual product, so it kind of like makes more sense to you. But the steps which I'm now going to go through is very, very simple. All I'm going to do is just line those up on there, get the pair of scissors, which is here somewhere, and then go snip on the end. So then I've got a piece of wire which is exactly the right length for here, and then I'll pre-tin the wire here. Again, just use a little bit of sanding paper, sanding pad, plenty of solder, and then pre-tin and get that stuck in. I'll do those horizontally, then I'll do those as well, and then we'll join them up each of the cells to make our final 4S pack, and then we'll get the balance lead in and the power connector as well. Howdy. So I've been in soldered on all the tabs. Okay, so we've done positive to positive, negative to negative, and I've done it both sides. Now, just be fully aware that you need to keep metal implements well away from this battery pack, because there is now a potential that you could short the battery. And I can tell you, unfortunately, I did that on my desk with another pack while I was building it, put it to one side, did something for a couple of hours, came back, put it down on top of a scales, stupid mat to check the weight, and it went. And if you look on my electronic scales, which we'll probably see at the end, there's burn marks on it. So you have to be very, very careful of this battery pack now, because it is now very, very, very close to being live. Okay. Now, a couple of tips for you as I went through this is, number one, when you're cutting out your nickel wire, is that don't be afraid to go back and trim a bit more off, okay? Because when I first did it the first time around, on one of the sides, they were perhaps a little bit too long, okay? The other thing is as well, do not skimp with the flux. There was one which I really did struggle with, so make sure you sand on both sides of both of the tabs which you're gonna do it, that you put a little bit of flux on both sides and then put the solder on. Pre-tinning is the term for that. And then make sure you do the opposite side as well, because with this pack, don't forget, not only do I need to connect these cells up, is that we also need to connect them horizontally as well, and we also then need to solder on our main battery connector for the positive terminal and the negative terminal, and we've got a balance needs to do as well, so make sure you pre-tin both sides of them. Now, this is where I'm actually going to say the guys which are out there and have got more professional, should I say, or more accurate soldering irons, is that there were a few instances where I did struggle with this cheapo soldering iron, okay? And where I struggled was on these big on the big flat ends, is because if you think about it, on the positive terminal, which if I grab one of these, okay, with the positive terminal, they're a bit, like I said, it's protruding away from the main cell itself. So we can get quite a bit of heat in there very, very easily. But with the bottom of the cells is that I really did struggle getting the heat through the solder from the soldering iron on there. And there was a real obvious dip in the temperature of the soldering iron. Now, the way which I combated that is, again, my mate, the blowtorch. Is that all I did was just got the blowtorch, and you may have seen it in the replay, and all I did was just heating up the nib on the soldering iron to a crazy heat, and then that was what allowed me to get the solder to go through the top of the nickel strip all the way down into the solder on the base as well. And what I will go and do is just go and get a little small screwdriver, and I will just probe each and every single one of these soldering pads just to make sure that we have a really good connection between the nickel wire and the cell itself. And then once I've put the long strips on here as well, that's something which I will also repeat as well. Now, do not skip that step. Is to make sure you have a really good weld or solder joint to each of the joints, because one of those loose, even if we've got tape around there holding it down in place, is that we don't want to have any dry joints in there. That's what it's called, a dry joint, just a dry joint, and that's not what you want to happen. Okay, so for just like a couple of seconds, just going around and just teasing the end and seeing if it comes away. In this state, it's very, very simple to fix. But imagine that this is a couple of months on and you've noticed that the battery really isn't performing as well. This should be about around 10,000 milliamperes. And if it's not performing as well as what it should be, you could have had a cold solder joint in here somewhere and not realized it. So just for the sake of 20-30 seconds, just probing each one just to make sure there really is a good joint on there, is definitely worth the investment of 20-30 seconds or so, if that makes sense. The next stage is what we need to do is that we need to join these batteries up, and I'm going to be honest with you, I did make two mistakes before this, and this is the third time lucky, because what I was originally going to do was just put the wires across the bottom, which was, whoa, bad, Matt. What we need to do is that we use this as our positive terminal here. We need the power to go down this cell, up this one, round here, and then down and back out again. Okay, so we have our positive here, so we then need to join up the bottom to the negative to the positive on these two cells. Then we need to do the top two cells, and then the current comes down, and then out of the bottom two cells. Okay, this is what I mentioned. You need to know what you're doing, because Matty, I'm putting my hand up here, I'm saying I made, the first time I recorded this, I made a mistake. The second time I recorded it, I also made a mistake, and it wasn't until I paused just to make sure, no, that doesn't sound right. Now I'm 100% confident in what I'm doing, okay? So if you are not 100% confident in what you're doing, stop. Check again, go back to a diagram, look at if you're watching either this video or someone else's video, make sure you know what you're doing. So let me just quickly recap. That's my positive terminal up there, so that I'm going to join up these two cells here, so the negative and the positive here. Then on the top, I'll then do the negative and the positive, and then here I'll do the negative and the positive, and then that allows the current to flow up around for each of the cells, which then gives us the 4S 2P battery pack, which we've got here. Now, for advanced users, you may be wondering, well, Matt, can I solder up both of these? Yes, of course you could do that if you wanted to. I'm not just for speed, in short. And again, the maximum, again, 40 amps, going through this little piece of wire is going to be more than adequate. And again, this battery pack is only ever going to end up in the nano talon, in the mini talon. So what did I say? Yeah, any cruise anywhere between 4 and 7 amps, and anything up to 25 amps, worst case 30 amps. So we'll never be pushing the top end of this battery pack. What we will be pushing is the actual capacity, not its ability to deliver current. So yeah, for my pack, I will only be soldering up one tab for this, because that just makes sense to my use case scenario. If you're going to be up near the limit of 40 amps, maybe you're going to be using this battery pack, say, in an XUAV client, which has got two motors, and will easily pour a 40 amps or more, then yes, I would double these up. But for my use case, just makes sense. It just fits ease. I'm just going to do one set. And then again, that cuts down the heat, which is going into the cells. And also, just a note here is that this kind of makes sense why you would give this task to someone else or get it pre-set up for you. And like I said, there are companies out there, search on the Googler, and they will pre-spot weld this for them. And again, if you had a spot welder, you would have done this in absolutely no time compared to soldering it and having to use the blowtorch and things like that. So anyway, let's go and get these little tabs done, and I'll be back to you by the magic of video editing in now.
Right, we're into a cup of coffee.
Soldering almost done. So let me just quickly recap what we've got here. And I've got a Sharpie pen, all right, to make this a little bit easier. And we'll get ourselves zoomed right in as well. So what we've got here is positive, negative, negative, positive, negative, and positive, and negative. Okay, so I hope that makes sense. So this is going to be our positive terminal here. This is where we're going to connect our red wire up. And what we've got now is that we'll have our red wire going to our battery pack there, coming down. And then you'll see that we've joined up these two cells. Okay, so we've now got negative to positive. Okay, the current's going to come up. And then it's going to come across here, down, here, across. And then out our final negative terminal, which is just there. Now, like I said, joining up the opposite two cells is completely up to you. Don't forget, current will make its way across, and they're fine. I think you're going to be absolutely fine with that. That's really up to you. Now, just as a quick sanity check, is that what I've got here to my left is a multimeter. Again, you really wouldn't be doing this if you didn't have a multimeter, or at least know how to use one. So if we just go across from the positive terminal to the negative terminal, we should be looking at around 16 some volts on there. So right, there we go, 15.2 volts, okay, or 15.19. That's kind of what we're expecting. It's a 4S pack. None of these cells have been charged. They've literally just been and turned up here. And that's classed as happy days. So if we now just quickly measure the cell voltages, so this is what our balance lead is going to be doing, is that not only with the first wire and the last wire, we'll be doing our full 15.2 volts or 16 volts, okay, it'll be the 4S, but across one cell, we've got...
Is that right?
Yeah, let's go. So there we go, some 3.8 volts, which is mostly charged, if that makes sense, ish. Okay, now we're going to do, so that'll be our 1S reading. Now we'll go to here and here. So we should be looking for double that. So that should be around the 8 volt mark, which it is. So that's a 2S battery pack. Now we need to do 3S, which is, will be from the positive terminal down to here. And then we are seeing... completely incorrect voltage. And I've just noticed there's a delivery van turning up. So there's our 3S battery pack at 11.8 volts. And we saw the final one here. So yeah, happy days, exactly what I was expecting and exactly what you should be expecting now. Just, it's just all you're doing, it's just adding the voltages in because they are all in series, okay? And like I said, you could put the tabs across the top if you so wish, but that's not what I'm gonna be doing on mine. What I now need to do is go and make our XC60 connector. So I'll have a black or, red wire coming from about this far out. And this is one of the nice things about these kind of battery packs. I've done a standard like slanted shape because that's what makes sense for me in the mini talon. I can stuff it in there. But if you needed a battery of a random design or somewhat bespoke to meet your own requirements, so for example, maybe you needed to make a strange pack where you have, again, I'm going careful with that pack, maybe where you needed 4 cells, or maybe you wanted a 6S and you wanted to make it like that, where those cells are up on an angle, or maybe you wanted to make a 4S battery pack like that, or make a square one, or whatever design or layout of battery cells you wanted, you can do that with these cells, because the only thing which is holding you back is either your imagination or your use case, something which I perhaps missed earlier on in the beginning. Actually, I'm going to cut this back into the beginning, because when it comes to these 18650 packs, you're not like saying you've got to have a rectangular pack like a typical LiPo. If you've got a specific use case, then heck, you could make a little 3S like that, or a 3S like that, or a 5S like that. It's really the only thing which comes to the creation of the battery and the setup, the way they're laid out, really is just down to A, your imagination, and B, the practicality of getting the wires to go across them. So yes, while, as you'll find out later on, we've got a pack which looks like this, and that's just the standard shape. If you want to do a shape like that, or make a 3-cell or a 4-cell, or do them that way round, or make a square, that is completely up to you. That's one of the nice things about these Lion packs, because you are the battery builder. You get to choose the layout which suits your own circumstances. So I tell you what, let's cut back to the main video and we'll carry on. Right, happy days. Let's move that across. Battery pack is almost completed. So what I'm going to quickly do is that we're going to have a quick wander around the wiring so that hopefully you feel confident in what's going on. Now, the thing to note here before we go any further, it's really important that you've got a battery meter or a multimeter. And also, just as a sanity check, I've got another 4S pack here. And when it comes to the balance lead itself, is that if we just plug it in like so, is that we're using this pack here, we know what to expect, okay? And then when we go through each of the cells, they're roughly matched, but it is, for all intents and purposes, this is a correct battery, okay? And that's really handy, because then you can use this as a reference, is that if we ignore the colours inside the balance lead, the only two colours which we're interested in is the top and the bottom, so the black and the red. And then if we measure the voltages between the red one, in this case a green one, remember your colours may be different on your balance lead, so on this bottom one, is that we may have, that's our ground, and then the voltage between the black one and the green one will be 3.7 volts, so we're only measuring one cell. And then the difference between the black one and the yellow one, okay, is 2 cells, so that will now be, say, 8.4 volts on a fully charged one, and then between the black one and the white one, we are expecting a 3S battery pack, okay, so that'll be 11 point something volts, and then, of course, the 4S pack in this case, because the balance lead connects are on here, because we're in a 4S pack, that will be 16 point something volts, assuming it's fully charged, okay? We're expecting increments of 3.7, okay? So with that in mind, this is how I've been wired mine up, okay? And it should be exactly the same for yourself. So if we take the positive, and again, I'll put these side by side, you know that you got this the right way round because of the arrows. And again, I used that 4S battery pack just a few moments ago just to make sure that I was doing it right. So we've got the red wire on the left, okay? And then we've got the black wire on the right. Now it's a little bit confusing because these wires are all black, but this was the best 4S balance lead which I had. They're nice silicone wires, and then once you're doing them, it is very straightforward, which is the red wire is the obvious. We need that to go to the positive terminal, so we've got the positive terminal here, Okay, and the other side, on the opposite side of the balance lead connector, it's going to the negative terminal, which is just there. Of course, that leaves you three wires in between. Now, what do you do with those three wires? Well, it's really kind of obvious when you think about it. So if we start from the negative terminal, which was that one there, so that's going all the way over here, is that we then want the second wire up, so it needs to be 3.7 volts, so we need to measure the other end of the battery. So we want to measure that cell there, so that's what that wire has been soldered down to the bottom. The third one, we need to do two cells, so we now need to do the top, which is that one up there, so anywhere up here would have been fine. Okay, and then the last one needs to do three cells, so one, two, three. Brilliant, and that's what it's been soldered up to. And the sanity check is that if we grab our battery tester, so I'm just gonna plug that in, and ta-da, 15.14 volts. That's what our battery pack is right now. Quickly click on cells. There we go, and that's actually exactly why we need to balance lead connector on here, because two of the cells have got a much higher voltage, or 0.1 volt, compared to the other cells, and that's why when you balance charge it with your charger, is that it will even that out as well, and you'll see there's some slight discrepancies between each group of cells in there. But overall, we are seeing our 4S pack, which is happy days. It's telling us it's 4S at the top, and we've got 15.14 volts, which is definitely happy days. And then I went on. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, we've just been here in the wire bin, and I would have ideally liked to have used this thicker wire. And again, this is one of the beauties of building your own packs, is that I would have preferred to have used some 12 AWG wire for this pack. Not because it requires such thick wire, it's because I like such thick wire. So we've quickly been over there on eBay and ordered some more, but I've had to go with some, I think this is 14 AWG, turn it around so I can read on there somewhere. Yeah, well, I'm using 14 AWG cable, which, to be honest, this Hobby King pack, that's all it's using as well. And this battery is up to 52 amps, okay? So this pack is not, is it? Well, we could do 40 amps for it with those cells, maybe a little bit more of the odd spike. But to be honest, I would have preferred the thicker wire because, hey, look, I'm building my own pack. If I want to put thicker wire in it, I'll put thicker wire in it. But I can't do that today because I haven't got any. I've got this one piece of black, which is a bit frustrating. So, and you'll also notice I've made up quite a long lead on here. Now, the reason why I've made it quite a long lead is that when I'm taping this up, what I will do on purpose is make sure that I tag, okay, and make a little loop back like so in the cable on the end. Okay, again, this makes it perfect for my mini talent. I'll be able to slot, I'll do it that way round. Turn it round, again makes more sense that way round, so that now slots in the nose, okay, or I'll have a look, I'll go and check in the mini talent which way, is it better I do it that way, or do I need the slope in front on the end? To be honest, it probably makes, actually, like that would probably be better, wouldn't it? So I'll have the pigtails coming up out the top, so I'm not having to come out the side and then having a bit of a faff. It's going to make it easier for me when we go to connect up the battery, because the battery pigtail is going to be coming out of the middle. And then I will make sure that we've got some slack in here. And the reason why we've got some slack in there is because when I'm pulling stuff, the charger and things like that, I don't want to put any strain on the wires and down to the solder joints, so that I will build in this little bit of slack into the system itself. So there you go, that's my 5200 pack. All I now need to do is wrap it in glass weave tape just to make sure everything stays put in the right place. And like I said, I've got some colour tape here somewhere underneath the desk. Quickly grab that out from underneath. It's just some red tape. And all I'm going to do is pop some red tape over it just to make it look pretty. And again, we've got, if we had a bit of an unscheduled landing, it's easier to spot a brightly coloured item in the grass or tree or wherever the model and the battery pack has been and ended up. So I will pop some red tape around in there just so it stands out on there, and it makes it look pretty. Or one last tip is that make sure you get your Sharpie pen and write on what the pack is. So again, it might be obvious to me and you, but later on you might sell the pack or give it away or forget. So writing on there, 10,000 milliampere, and it's the, Lightog color batteries, and then 10,000 milliampere, 4S at 2p. If you write that on there, then happy days. And again, I've had that before with little 3S packs, in, even on the main charger, which I've got some little Diddy 3S packs, which look almost exactly the same as the little Diddy 4S packs. There's only like a few mil between them. So yeah, do take the time just to write on the pack on the final tape at the end, so you know what's in the pack. Because today you know exactly what's in there. Roll on a couple of months or maybe years, because remember, these batteries are, the tolerances on them are up to like 500 cycles, so 500 charges like minimum. So that, yeah, when you used it for a year or so, you might have forgotten what's in that pack. So do take a moment just to draw on the top. So I'm gonna go and get this one taped up, and by the magic of video editing, I'll be back to you now.
10,000 milliamp hour 4S26650.
Jobs are good. So very much happy days. So let's put this into perspective. We have spent, or I have spent, $4 per cell, okay, and there's 8 of those in there, so 8 times 4 is £32, $32, and I definitely didn't just use my calculator on my phone. So $32 plus a few accessories, a little bit of nickel tape, nickel wire, a balance lead, which I already had here. I had the cable, I had the wire here as well, the connectors. I had all the bits and bobs here. So yeah, we'll say $32 all in plus a little bit of extra for the bits which we just mentioned. So we'll say about £27. I think so. Actually, that's not bad value for money, because these are the 5200 multi-star packs, or not far off that on full retail. So yeah, and they're only half the capacity of one of these almost. So yeah, 10,000 milliamperes 4S pack, crazy numbers to say the least. Now let's go and get the scales out, because you must be wondering how much does this weigh. So I need to put this round so it's nice and level, which it is now. Right, that's been zeroed out. Happy days, just put this on. And by the way, remember I said about the mistake which I made? Can you spot the brain marks on the scales? Right, so this battery comes in at 824 grams. Now in ounces, that is, say, 29 ounces worth. But yeah, 824 grams, 10,000 milliamperes, with, and that's got 40, oh, I need to put that on there, 40 amps max. I put 40 amps or 40A on there so I know that. And then maybe compare that to, yeah, so like for like, this is the thing, 434, so 800, yeah, this is a curiosity one, especially when you compare to lipos, because for me, this is going to be perfect for the mini Talon. 10,000 milliamperes and a nice little pack like this. Squash it down in the nose, happy days. And I need to put some Velcro on the bottom. But do keep in the back of your mind, what I was saying at the very beginning is that I've been and made a 4S2P pack. But you could make any size cell. So maybe you wanted a 4S 3P pack and get to 15,000 milliamperes if you wanted to. You're only like stuck by your imagination or the way which you can attach these batteries to each other to make your own custom cells. That's probably one of the biggest, again, one of the unsung biggest points when it comes to Lion packs, is that you can create them in odd shapes and sizes if you need to. You're not restricted to a rectangle brick. You can make your own custom batteries to which meet your own model and personal requirements to what you require at the flight time for your batteries. So personally, I'm very impressed with this pack. I can't wait to get this one out on the flight line. One massive, very serious point for you to take away is that if you have made your own pack, remember the first time you charge this, you make sure that it's in a fire bag and you are around while the battery is being charged. And the one of the guys which I fly with, his garage burnt down because of a battery which he bought from a sale. And unfortunately, that literally, you put it on to balance charge and it burnt his garage down. So it does come with a very serious real life challenge when it comes to these, is especially if you made it your battery yourself. That's why we were saying back at the beginning, make sure you know exactly what you're up to. And even I freely put my hands up when I make mistakes, is that I did make two mistakes and got to the third one, which was the right way of showing you to connect and not the balance lead and the little joints, sorry, not the balance lead, the solder tabs. It's because I also almost made a mistake. Okay, and if I almost made a mistake, that doesn't mean that you could almost make a mistake. So be 100% confident in what you're doing. So all in all, for $32, I'm very happy, and I'm gonna, like I said, gonna get this one charged, and it'll be in the mini Talon. Look out for some flight footage in the near future. And also, actually, before I go, is that while this battery may be rated up to 10,000 milliamperes, just please apply some common sense. What I will be doing with this battery pack is the first time I use it, I may only push maybe 5,000 milliamperes, have a really good jolly around, not go very far either, okay, and then come back and make sure it really is charged. If my EagleTree Vector or whatever OSD which I'm using tells me that we've pulled 5,000 milliamperes out of it, make sure that we're putting 5,000-ish back in. Okay, and if it's not, go and get that calibrated. And then slowly nudge, maybe go to 6,000 milliamperes, then 7, and then maybe 8. And keep a very, very close eye on what your voltage is and what your current capacity is, because that's the last thing which you want to do, is just go out, fly it into the ground, because you've taken it up to 10,000 and then found out that the battery really does go off a cliff at the very end. And also just be aware with Lion battery packs, they go, although these ones specifically go from 4.2 all the way down to, I think it's 3.7, but some Lion packs will go all the way down to 2.5 volts if they don't have any current or protection boards in the top of them. So make sure you know your batteries exceptionally well. So, on that note, from myself, Matt, thank you very much for taking the time to join me to build this monster battery pack for the Mini Talon. Really looking forward to getting this one out. Any questions or comments, please let me know down in the comments section underneath this video. Remember, I will include links to everything which I've been in used in mine. Again, the links to these batteries which were on Aliexpress for, $40 for 10. Dirt cheap, and we did speak about the 18650 batteries earlier. Don't skimp on the X18650 batteries, do go for the LG ones. Again, I'll put the exact ones down in the video description. They are exceptionally good, and again, you saw me, I took them out of my Fat Shark goggles because they are just so good. Okay, and on that note, if you've been enjoyed this chit chat about 18650s and building this pack, do me a favor, hit the thumbs up. And on that note, as always, for myself, Matt, thank you very much for taking the time to watch this episode. And I'll see you again shortly. Cheerios!